you want to introduce yourself and what piece you're going to play?
Okay, I'm Lorin, and I'm playing Etude number 3 from the Italian Studies book.
What year are you?
I'm a sophomore.
Only sophomore?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
What major?
I'm a music education major.
Okay, good. And you're playing, what piece are you playing? One of the Italian Caprices, right?
Yes.
Okay. It's page 26, number 3. Okay. So musically, what do you want to achieve?
It has a lot of dramatic, dynamic markings.
Uh-huh.
And so I want to make a lot of dynamic contrast.
Good. What else?
And it also has a lot of contrasting styles.
Uh-huh.
And so I want to bring those out.
Okay, let's go for it.
Okay.
So who is Cavallini? Oh, that's the question I never asked you before.
No.
Okay, so he's the clarinet player who was used by Verdi.
Okay.
He has a lot of operas. You know, think about it. His La Forza Destino, Verdi. He wrote a solo just for Cavallini.
Oh, okay.
So later on, he became the clarinet professor from St. Petersburg Conservatory. So you can tell there's lots of operatic writing here, right?
Mm-hmm.
He himself is a good composer. You know, most famous one probably is the one they are doing, I believe it's an introduction and a rondo, a caprice.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of high school kids, they are playing. Lots of rubato. We're talking about being rhythmic, but this part you can feel free a little bit. A lot of time happens in the 32nd note. Right there. One, and da 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 da.
Okay,
this kind of, you can do more rubato. Nice tone, nice dynamic change. So what was your challenge when you play that piece?
I think the dynamic markings.
Uh-huh.
And then like some of these like bigger leaps.
Oh, good. No, dynamics, that was great. The big leaps, just think about it, string players, bow, bow, pow, they will reset. So a little bit more space. Right. What kind of preparation you have to have when you play big jobs?
Your air,
that's good. Air is always the right answer to us. Okay, what's second? What's the next? What takes to play high notes?
You have to voice them.
Voicing. The tongue position, right?
Yeah.
What else?
Fingerings.
What else?
Like your embouchure?
Yeah, everything. So, good. Luckily, you only have two eighth notes in between, so get prepared earlier. You can practice high G first. Can you make a high G really pretty? That's good. Now, in the context of music, you have to react to that particular physical condition right away. Embouchure, air, much sooner. So, to the Do, E, less time, more air. Good, one more time. Yes. And also, it's nice to check the tune to see where the intonation is.
Okay.
That finger you were using is kind of nice for the scales. Can you try this particular one on your clarinet? Yeah.
Okay.
Try that. Yeah. Try it. D to G. Good. So check with the tuner. I think this fingering might sounds better with the clarinet. What do you think?
Yeah.
And also that fingering is good for the arpeggiation. Right, it's hard to use that, right?
Yeah.
So I will use that one.
Okay.
Good. All right. Let's try some rubato stuff here. I want you to listen to the La Forza di Destino. There's one particular aria with huge clarinet solo. It just sounds just like that. But for now, I want to play three times and then use more dynamic contrast. And then use more variety of the rhythm and tempo to make it sound really musical. How's that?
Okay.
Try stuff out right there. First time. Second time. So are there any rules to make rubato? No rule or yes, sort of? What do you think? If you're gonna be a great teacher, I know that.
I guess.
So the kids say, I don't want to do whatever I want.
You should follow like the contour of the music.
Good, follow the contour. So for me, sometimes it works really well. So you have the same direction, I will go either go slower or faster and go and change the contour, you change a little bit melody, change the speed a little bit. And also in terms of the end of the phrase, normally harmonic intention is more, okay, 5-2-1 or 5-2-6 or secondary dominant 2-5. So those places you can take more time too.
Okay.
So think about that way. So play the second time. Do something a little bit different. Maybe in the middle a little bit faster.
Okay.
A little bit, ooh, like that. That'd be really cool. Okay. Let's do two more times. You tell me which one you like the best.
Okay.
Every time, sometimes just leave Nina to be play a couple times those passages. Try. Oh, that was really nice. Next one, next time. Oh, not next time. One more time. Let's
okay.
do one more time. Thank you. musical. No, you're going to be the principal player in the opera pit. It's underneath the stage. Can you do the same musical idea, but come on much, much more?
Okay.
Think about that way. Try it. Rotondo or rotondo. I will do a little bit faster first. Di da 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 di da di da da di la da di la da di la da di la.
Oh, okay.
That's preparation for the high G. You want to try it?
Yeah.
Okay. Di yo do di. Challenges.
It goes through lots of different keys.
Ah, okay.
So getting through all the keys, right?
So, do you have any strategy for that?
So
it's a transition period, moving from G major, moving away from G major, but later on go back to G major. Okay, in the middle section. Mm-hmm. If you see, if you feel like harmony is very unstable, that means there are transition. Okay.
Okay.
So, do you have any strategy to work on that? I'm listening.
Okay. Like practicing the scales that go with each key.
Oh, okay, wow, you're going to be very busy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or,
of course, helps when we do scales. What else?
Slow practice.
Slow practicing. What about write down the harmony itself? What do you think?
Oh, like write, like which chords it's arpeggiating?
Duh! Okay, for example, the first measure, what kind of harmony is this? Theory test. Your theory professor are watching.
D?
So you have a D, F sharp.
D7?
Yes, D, F sharp, A, C, right?
Yes.
So D7 chord. I will write down the beginning of them.
Okay.
Yeah, just like those jazz players. They're so good at stuff, don't you
yeah.
agree?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so think of you when you look at that symbol, you won't feel confused. Now, this one, it's mainly is G minor with C there, right?
Uh-huh.
So at least you can write it down here, G minor. So you know the most of the part of that measure is G minor.
Okay.
And on the top, it's very visible, right?
Mm-hmm.
What about after that? What is it? So you have B flat, you have D, F, and F.
B flat major?
B flat major, that's right. In the key of G major, it's flat 3, okay? By the way, let's don't go into there. So, and all the parallel on the top is our rhythm C on the top. The bottom, basically, is all the chords, right?
Okay.
So
yeah.
That's the one very good way to study those pieces, right? And then staring at each individual of those notes, you need to just look at a bigger picture, okay?
Okay.
So this is one issue. So another thing is, I would love to have you to clippy more, fingerhead more. Oh,
okay.
Always going to be right there. Sometimes the clipping, you are doing clipping, but the note is not short enough just because your tummy is not support.
Okay.
So we clip your D. Okay, we try it very slow. So even before that, okay, your strategy is going to be slur all the time. Slur entire piece, regardless what kind of articulation patterns you are going to have.
Okay.
Why we do that? Just because I tell you so? No.
I don't know.
Yeah. You get nervous in the front of the camera. I did not tell you we're going to tape it today, so it just surprise you. That's good. I like that. So, in order to do slur, so the purpose for that is make a good sound at all time.
Oh, okay.
It's hard to make a good sound right away with your articulation, right? So, slur first and make more shape out of it. Very slow practicing, too. Can we just try first four measures, please? Big wave, big wave. Push. Good. Yeah. And also you see the tonito underneath those low notes, right? Think about big cello. I will stretch those downbeats a little bit more.
Okay.
You do the crescendo, it's okay, but still need to have a little bit more weight on the first and third note,
okay,
which is the beginning of those arch, right? Try that. Yes. Yes. Push. Good. Breathe faster. That's beautiful. Now, let's do clipping.
Okay.
One, two, ready, go. The clipping, I cannot hear it. I heard. Air. Yes, that's it. Almost like I push extra air at the end of that clipping,
okay,
to make that note come out. And what's the purpose to have fingerhead technique?
So it sounds clean.
That's right. You're clipping it, and then you create a silence, and then you use that silence to get your next note ready.
Okay.
It's always like that way, right?
Uh-huh.
With articulation scales, which will go first? Air, your fingers, or your notes, or your fingerings?
Your fingers.
Or your tongue. So air, fingering, or your tongue?
Your fingers.
So you also you have air first, right?
Right.
And then you have your, no, you're right. Fingering first, fingerhead technique.
Like,
duh, I was talking about, yes. Get your finger ahead and then go for it. Okay, try that. One, two, three, go. More air. Push. Push.
which one?
Those big leaps, even more fingerhead technique, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right, that it's hard. Try that. Yes, start from major before. It's kind of funny, you know why? Because I told you in the middle section you just played it.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very transitional passages. Harmonically, it's not very unstable.
Yeah.
Right, and then he moved from G major to 5/5, and then eventually go to B minor, and then you have a flat 2, which is near part of 6 chord.
Oh.
Is that fun?
Yeah.
Serious fun, just say it.
Serious
fun.
Lots of fun.
Okay.
Serious fun.
Good. And then, you know, all those transition periods you have moving from B major minor to G sharp, and then you have E, have G sharp to B to E major. All those, they gradually modulate because
mm-hmm.
they keep the same note from the previous chord.
Oh, okay.
So you see, you have B major, you have a B there, you have an E major, you have a B still there. So it's kind of gradually modulating.
Huh.
Is that cool?
Yeah.
And sometimes become major 7 and go to 1 again. I had a lesson before you, and one of my students, he said, can you talk about theory a little bit more? So try to understand the structure of the piece itself. I think probably that's a good idea.
Huh.
It's more fun, especially those harmonically unstable fingerings.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let's go to the end. Can we go a little bit faster? Now, let's go back to more free tempo again. Right?
Okay. Uh-huh.
People say, da, 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 da. This is like, the opening again, like aria. Okay? Visually, I already know all those 32nd notes you can take a little bit more rubato. And all the places, for example, the second line for the end, rhythmically it's kind of unstable, right?
Yeah.
And then you can do more freedom there too.
Okay.
Can we try it?
Yeah.
Okay. Be more musical in terms of dynamic contrast as well as place a variety of the tempo to make
okay.
that work. Try it.
How fast?
63. Those notes have a little accent mark there. How to interpret that? All those G and E have an accent. What does that mean?
Put more emphasis on that note.
How?
With your air.
Of course, duh! It's obviously it's too much fun. So use your tummy.
Okay.
Like street players, they might have to use your more vibrato. So, of course, we don't do vibrato here.
Mm-hmm.
So I would do it not to front of ear. But lots of middle school kids, they play like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Try that. Can you do even faster crescendo?
Okay.
Good. Right, faster crescendo and then professional right away.
Okay.
So that's the hard part, because it's only happened within that single beat.
Uh-huh.
You can do it. Can you say, huh?
Huh.
Not enough. You always use your throat. Huh.
Oh.
Huh.
Huh.
That's right. Do it again. Huh.
Huh.
That's right. All right. Let's try it. Now this is more like a clarinet play. And then think about opera singers here. Make up words.
Make up words.
Yeah, make up words. Is that sad? Is that sad or that's happy there?
It sounds pretty happy.
It's funny you say that. I feel like it's a little bit sad.
Really?
But that's the power. You know, it's part of music. The reason you think it's happy because it's major, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I feel like this is like. Okay, make up a words. So all those accent notes, they're supposed to have some more meaning about the text. So if you study German lead, okay, or opera, this is called text painting.
Okay.
So any particular words, it have a special harmony to make that happen. Can you make up a words? Okay, so today I want to practice really good. Something like that.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So think about that and then play it. Music is a language, right?
Uh-huh.
Yes, it's an international language. So no matter you speak Hebrew, Chinese, or English, you name it.
Okay.
Sometimes if we out of our own music idea, you can make up a words.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Uh-huh.
And you can feel happy, you can say something really good about people with your music, or you can, you know, say bad words with your music. I don't know. To always be something. Okay,
yeah.
Try it. More vocalized. Curtain goes all the way down, and the princess can start to come on the stage to sing an aria.
Ooh.
Is that cool?
Yeah.
It's the end, almost like a little interlude between different scenes.
Huh.
So think about that. This book is great. Man. I love that book. It's so hard,
mm-hmm.
but it's so musical.
Yeah.
I don't want anything that's a very technical etude.
No, it doesn't seem like an etude.
No, it's not. Yeah. So I want you to listen to more opera.
Okay.
To make it really sounds more like opera singer. And, you know, in terms of rhythmic pattern, when needs to be more rhythmic is when you see a solo line or accompaniment, if you play the orchestra, it's a very consistent rhythm, stay the same. And if you see nothing happen underneath you, and then you start to do lots of rubato stuff.
Okay.
In this case, it's lots of rubato. You have all the cadenzas indicated on the page. So you can use a lot of freedom. How's that?
Mm-hmm.
Any more questions about that piece, how to practice?
I don't think so.
Good. I like that good sound. That's a good read.
Thank you.
Good smile, too. Okay.